My whole family didn't follow my mother when I went no contact. They were always with her. If they weren't, I would not have been the victim of child abuse. They knew things were wrong, and they chose the family facade, the appearance of family, over a little girl who was painted into being the family liar and a troublemaker and all these different things beginning at the age of 4. And for all I know, it started before then. That's just my earliest memory. Where they did begin to call was when the no contact was happening, especially when I walked away from my grandfather. I got a phone call from my brother, who I was already not speaking to, telling me he would never speak to me again and what a horrible human being I was. My grandfather was a child molester. And then on top of that, my aunt, the one who I loved so much that apparently I have really had these very thick rose-colored glasses on with, also called me, not when I went no contact with my mother, but when I went no contact with my grandfather. And it came to light after that, that she knew that he was doing something. The only time the family in a narcissistic family system comes to your side is to manipulate you and to draw you back in and to maintain the status quo. They don't like to lose the supply. And they definitely don't like other people to know that something is wrong with the family. So that's the other part of painting you as the bad guy. You're the only one walking away, therefore you're the bad guy. That narrative began way before the no contact. If you look back at it, it began at the beginning.